freeintromusic.com layout track.
Good morning, students. Once again, welcome in DSS online classes. Myself, C. Yadav. And today we are going to discuss the next topic of political science. Chapter 3, Election and Representation. Our today's chapter is Election and Representation, and the new topic, that is Proportional Representation in Israel. Proportional Representation in Israel, it's our today's topic. And students, we discussed in last video a system of election which is applied in our country, that is the first past the post system. First past the post system. According to this system, the candidates who stands in a particular constituencies, they win the election and the people, the citizen of the country, vote for them. Our whole country is divided into several constituencies, and every constituencies has the candidates of each political parties. They contest and they get the votes, which vote was called in the election, and the candidate who get maximum vote, that candidate is announced विक्टर, विनर उसे घोषित कर दिया जाता है. बट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इज़राइल, वेयर दिस सिस्टम इज नॉट अप्लाइड, एंड वेयर द प्रोपोर्शनल रिप्रेजेंटेशन इन इज़राइल, द प्रोपोर्शनल पीआर सिस्टम, प्रोपोर्शनल रिप्रेजेंटेशन सिस्टम, इन विच द होल कंट्री इज नॉट डिवाइडेड इनटू सेवरल कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज, द होल कंट्री इज लाइक a one single constituency. All the political parties make the list of their candidates for the constituencies, but in every constituencies the people cast their vote in the favor of political party, not in the favor of a particular person, a particular candidate. The citizen cast their vote in favor of political party, and after casting the vote, when the votes are calculated, that means when the counting is done, there one very important thing would be seen, that is the percentage of votes saved, percentage of votes saved. In Israel, the legislature, that means the parliament's name is Knesset, and in Knesset, when the system of election is applied in the country, the political party which get minimum 3.25% votes here, that party is eligible to get seats in the parliament, seats in the Knesset. Otherwise, if any political party which get less than 3.2% of votes here, that party is not eligible to secure their seat in Knesset. In Israel parliament, that party is not eligible to secure any seat. And PR system is also used for the election of president, vice president, and the member of Rajya Sabha in India. Proportional representation system is applied in India in the election of vice president, president, and the member of Rajya Sabha. So, how this is calculated in the Rajya Sabha election? How it is calculated? You know, the members of Rajya Sabha are elected by indirectly system of voting in our country, and the representatives who are elected by the people for the assembly election, that means in Uttar Pradesh, 403 members are elected by the people directly in as MLA, member of legislative assembly. That means in the state legislative assembly, the members are elected who are eligible to cast his or her vote for the election of Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha ke candidate ke election ke liye jo hamare state assemblies ke yani ki member of legislative assembly ke jo members hote hain wo apna vote cast karte hain aur wah Rajya Sabha ke members ko chunte hain. To how it is calculated? Suppose just we take the example of Rajasthan where 200 members are there in assembly, and just example 4 members are to be elected. Rajya Sabha ke 4 members ko elect karna hai aur Rajya Sabha ke liye, aur Rajasthan mein 200 members hain wahan ke assemblies mein, to wo unko elect karenge. To ek formula hai, that formula is total votes polled upon total number of candidates to be elected. Total votes polled, that means 200 members of assemblies in Rajya Sabha, so 200 vote is total polled vote upon total number of candidates to be elected, yani 4 members ko elect karna hai. To 200 upon 4 plus 1, total of plus 1 equal to 40 plus 1 equal to 41. That means in Rajya Sabha, 4 members from Rajasthan se 4 members ko Rajya Sabha ke liye chunna hai. So in that